still got the snow melting. We're gonna go and have a look over in the cut and see as to what we're up against.
At Paradise Hill, Tony Beats is fighting a battle with snowmelt. After ditching and draining the blue cut, he's making a dawn inspection of the cold cut.
Oh, well, there you go. Well, that's a mess. We will not be working here today by the looks of it. So I bet you what we're gonna end up doing, move everybody into the blue cut and still continue on. Like, we're not shutting down because of it. This way we can keep on going. You always, always in the mining business have plan B. This year we got the two cuts on the go, just in case something like this would happen. I mean, there's still a pile of snow back here. There is a load of water coming from behind us, running in the cuts. We should dig the ditches. If we can keep them cuts dry, that's such a big plus, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, 100%.
I'll send them one more hole to give you a hand to dig the trenches. Okay?
Yep.
Okay, good enough.
James, do you copy? James, do you copy?
Yeah, copy, Tony.
I'm going to dig a ditch right from the cold cut all the way to the blue cut, right straight across the hill.
I'm on my way.
To save the cold cut and strengthen the blue cut's flood defenses, Tony is going to higher ground. His plan? Use the D11 dozer to blaze a 2,000-foot path across the back of both the cold cut and the blue cut. Then, in the 750 excavator, James will dig a 20-foot deep trench, removing 10,000 tons of dirt. This will catch up to 1.5 million gallons of snowmelt and divert the water away from both cuts, also allowing the cold cut to dry out. Twenty-four hours later, James has finally finished the trench above the cuts. The 2,000-foot trench will allow the cold cut to dry out and save both the cold cut and the blue cut from further flooding.
It's all done, so I think we should get back to get in the cut and load some more gravel on.
Sounds good to me.
Let's do it, guys.
Let's get at it.